So, what job would you consider to be the most stressful? Stress is defined as any circumstances that either threaten an individual's well-being or that the individual perceives as threatening their well-being. As a result, they require some sort of coping response to cope with the stress of the circumstance. When I've asked a room full of students in the past, what job would you consider to be the most stressful? The job the students mentioned that they would consider to be the most stressful job has often been a bomb disposal expert. Do you think the job of a bomb disposal expert would be really stressful? Do you think it would be more stressful than someone working in a bar, for example? Well, in 2005, Alexander Haslam and colleagues actually asked bomb disposal experts how stressful they found their job. And they also asked people who worked in bars how stressful they thought their job was. They found that people who worked in bars actually found their job to be more stressful than those who worked in bomb disposal. Haslam concluded that the reason for this is that bomb disposal experts work in a tight-knit team, and so they have each other for support. They also have a lot of job control and have a lot of control over their risk. As a result, they don't perceive their jobs as being very stressful. Whereas those working in the service industry, like in bars, actually find their jobs to be stressful. So it seems that jobs or events themselves are not inherently stressful. Now let me ask you a different question. Have you ever been skydiving? Those of you who have probably thought that it was fun. When looking at this photo of people skydiving, it looks like fun. Would anyone want to go skydiving because it looks terrifying and stress-inducing? Probably not. But skydiving is not for everyone though. The same event, skydiving, can be appraised as fun and a great way to spend your weekend, or absolutely terrifying. There's pretty much nothing you could say that would ever convince me to go skydiving, for example. So, what's stressful or not depends on our appraisal. Folkman identified two different types of appraisals that are important for dealing with stress: primary appraisal and secondary appraisal. Primary appraisal refers to the evaluation of whether a stressor is perceived as a threat or a challenge. For example, when studying for an exam, if the individual perceives the exam as a threat, they might think that everybody's going to find out that they've been slacking off during the semester and how they haven't really studied for the exam. They might think, this is going to be terrible, I'm going to do badly in the exam. Now that's a threat appraisal, and it's negative and highly stressful. Now, on the other hand, if the individual perceives the exam as a challenge, they might see it as an opportunity to demonstrate how much they know about the exam topic and how hard they've been working. They perceive the exam as an opportunity rather than a threat. The challenge appraisal is much more positive. Secondary appraisal refers to the evaluation of whether the individual has the necessary skills and resources for dealing with the stressor. Secondary appraisal does not only refer to the evaluation of whether the individual has the skills to deal with the stressor, but also the resources around them. So, for example, are there people who can help the individual when they need help? Therefore, it's both the individual's skills and whether they have the social support to cope with the stress. If the individual doesn't think that they have the skills and that they can't get the necessary social support, they'll appraise a stressful situation as being really stressful. It's also worth remembering that stress can be an everyday thing, or it can result from one-off events. Losing your phone can be stressful, not being able to get a park when you go to the shops can be stressful and annoying. Having a deadline for something can be really stressful. A natural disaster can be really stressful. However, what makes something stressful really depends on who the perceiver is and how they perceive the stressful situation.